Hi guys, I'm Azizul Muradi and welcome to Muradi Tutorial. Today in this video, I'm gonna show you how to shrink volume of C drive when we are not able to shrink volume of C drive. Keep watching.
Muradi Tutorial, transforming experience, presenting opportunities.
To get started with the shrinking C drive, right click on this PC, choose manage, select disk management. If you right click on C drive and click on shrink volume, you see here size of available shrink space in MB, that is 0. It means you cannot shrink any amount of volume on C drive. If I write here any amount, but it is still showing the button of shrink is grayed out, which means we cannot shrink any volume. So how can we solve this issue? We can solve this issue by disabling the paging file. Whenever you see the page file is turned on a drive, it means it prevents us from deleting any drive or shrinking volume. But guys, let me one thing absolutely clear for you. This does not happen all the time. Sometimes you see paging file on the C drive, but you can still shrink the volume. And also, when the paging file is turned on another drive, the same like C drive, you can shrink the volume on other drive, but you cannot delete the volume. It means paging file prevents us from deleting the drive 100%. But as we are concerned with the shrink option, paging file sometimes prevents us from shrinking the volume. Not all the time. C drive can never be deleted because the system file is on it, but we can shrink volume on C drive. Let's do it practically. Go to control panel, system and security, system, advanced system settings, advanced performance settings, advanced tab, click on change, antique, automatically manage paging file size. Make sure you have selected the C drive. Click on no paging file. Set system properties. If you disable the paging file or set the initial size to less than 800 megabytes and the system error occurs, Windows might not record details that could help identify the problem. Do you want to continue? You don't have to worry at all. Just click on yes. Click on OK for all Windows. In case at this stage, if it requires restart, just restart the computer after the closing all the Windows files and programs. If you see there is still a page file, it means you have to refresh the page. From here, you can refresh the page, or you can close and reopen it, or you restart your computer. I refresh from here. Refresh is not working. I reopen it. Still there is paging file, so I have to restart my computer. Okay guys, my computer has just been restarted. Let's go to disk management. Now you see there is not any paging file on C drive. Right click on C drive and choose shrink volume. It takes a little time. Now you see size of available shrink space in MB 52,314 MB. It is not 0. You can write the amount you want to shrink. For example, I shrink 10 GB. 10,000 MB. Shrink. It takes a little time. Now you see approximately 10 GB is unallocated. and the volume has been taken from the C drive. If you want to shrink more volume, you can do it again. Now, guys, the most important thing that I want to tell you is that the paging file on C drive is very important because it is an optional hidden system file on a hard disk that lets the system use physical memory more efficiently. The paging file allows the computer to perform smoothly by reducing the workload of the physical memory. So once you're done, you have to turn on the paging file back on a C drive. If you don't have it turned on other drives, that is not a problem. But C drive must have a paging file turned on. So for this, please go back to the paging file window and turn on the paging file for the C drive. Before we do this, I want to show you some more things, and that is, if you want to add this unallocated space to the D drive like this, you cannot do it because the extent volume is grayed out. What you have to do, first of all, you have to delete this 519 MB, the healthy recovery partition. For this, be sure to check out our video on our channel on how to extend a C drive. In that video, I have showed you how to delete this healthy recovery partition. When you go to Muradi YouTube channel, click on videos and choose hard drive partition, why can't I extend C drive. Check out this video. Yeah. So once you delete this healthy recovery partition, still you cannot add this unallocated volume to the D drive. Why? Because this is before D drive. You have to bring the drive you want to extend before the unallocated space. For that, after deleting the healthy recovery partition, you have to empty the D drive and delete the D drive. Once you delete the D drive, the unallocated of this D drive will be added to the unallocated space 9.77 GB. Then you can right click on the whole amount and make a new sample volume. That will be your D drive. For now, I want to insist once again, you have to turn on the paging file on C drive. It is important for your computer. Before I do that, I want to extend this back because I don't need to shrink volume from C drive. Okay, let's minimize this window. To turn the paging file on, you can also click on this PC and choose properties. Click on advanced settings. On advanced tab under performance, click settings, choose advanced tab and click on change. Here, make sure C drive is selected. Put a check mark in the box of system managed size. Click set. System managed. Put a check mark over there and click OK. Click OK for all windows. Close it. Once you have done it, you can reinstall your computer if it doesn't affect. First, you have to check if the paging file is on. Okay, the paging file is on my C drive. In case you do not see the paging file, you have to restart your computer. After the restart of your computer, if you see that there is not paging file, it means you didn't turn it on correctly. You have to go back to the paging file window and turn it on again. It is all done. Thank you guys for all your supports. If you still have any question, please write down on the comment section of this video. Thank you.